Let's jump over to our man, Teddy Kekstadt. Every Wednesday at 40 past the hour, we talk to Teddy. You can reach Teddy every trading day at forex-trading-unlocked.com. Teddy Kekstadt, good morning.
Good morning, Tommy. We got a lot to talk about today.
I bet we do, man. I was jumping around. We got a move, of course, this morning in the dollar and some action. But, man, we got some moves to kick off the new year, to say the least. Where do you want to kick things off, Teddy?
Okay, well, obviously the dollar's definitely been under pressure for the past couple days. I would like to start with the U.S. dollar Canada. You had a textbook head and shoulders pattern that was confirmed yesterday. You got a nice little follow through to the downside today. And you're aiming towards a 200-day moving average. You're not too far away from that. So I would be mindful of any U.S. dollar Canada trader out there that even if we get some dollar strength, I don't think you're going to find that in the U.S. dollar Canada. I think you have a nice short-term downtrend. Remember that it's been kind of neutral for the past couple of months trying to become a bull, and I really don't see that that's going to be able to manifest anytime soon. I think you're really going to be banging on support on that one. So that's definitely a key market to look at for as far as the Forex market is concerned.
Nice. Yeah, quite a pullback recently from almost 130 to 125, right? But you get that low of 123 back there recently towards the end of last year.
Right, right. So now when we go back to the other currencies, it's pretty interesting. If you look at the euro, it finally had a breakout to the upside today. Okay, now the pound has been trending for already the past basically 5-6 sessions. The U.S. dollar Swiss, you know, all in all, if you look at the euro and the Swiss, they've basically been in a very tight range for the past 3-4 months. And right now, you have the euro U.S. dollar that is finally breaking out to the upper part of that range. I would not expect much follow-through on this move. I think you have maybe at the best, we could get up to probably around 115.25 possibly as a top for the euro U.S. dollar, because there's a lot of nuances that I think they're going to put a drag on the euro, okay? So now the British pound, obviously because of oil, I think is going to be very strong moving forward over the next couple of months. I mean, we have oil now has hit that up into the $80 level in that new range, and I think we'll be pushing 90s before we see it, you know it in the next like week or two, you know. And if that if we get that follow through, I would expect to see strength in the British pound U.S. dollar continue. Okay, the euro U.S. dollar, like I said though, I don't think that's going to be a big driver. So right now the dollar index is very reflective of the fact that other currencies are gaining on the dollar currently in the short run. Okay, I would expect to see some divergence as far as the dollar index is concerned, probably arising after this week. You got to remember, we have a lot of economic numbers that come out today, tomorrow, and Friday, you know. So I mean, and then it's not just in the US, it's also in the EU and also in the UK. So now we already know that we have the Fed leaning towards raising rates 3, maybe 4 times this year, as far as Goldman brought up this recently, you know. Yeah. So that's already factored into the market, okay? But the oil trade is definitely on the table there. And if we don't see a pullback in oil, it doesn't matter if the interest rates do have a big significant move or not. You're going to see a big bounce again in the U.S. dollar yen. Like, notice how the dollar is selling off, and we have a breakout in the euro. We have a sell off in the Swiss. We have a rally in the pound. Australian dollar is making a new move high today. But if you look at the U.S. dollar yen, it's not getting battered at all. You know, it's holding up, and that's because of the oil trade. You know, I mean, no matter what, interest rates are already factored in. So now definitely oil becomes a factor, and I think you're going to see this divergence that, as the pound, for instance, continues to be a bull moving forward, as oil does, at least until it gets to around the $100 to $105 level. I think once you get into that area, then you'll probably see the pound fall back, you know, as far as the oil trade and even in the yen. But until we get to those levels, I think the trend's going to keep on going.
Yeah, quite the move in oil, man. This pound, even quite the move from 131 to 136, just like that. Lots of green bars involved, very few red bars. And crude, I mean, things got a little dicey there going back to where we were in terms of 62. You're talking about back in December 2nd. It's only January 12th. You're back to 82. We have that recent highs of $85. But now that we're above 81, 82, I mean, the last 6 weeks, Teddy, I know you know, but it's just been constant higher prices there. $100, very natural number, seems like, in our head. We haven't seen it in a while. We were over that number for a long period of time, man. Seems like it might be on its way to at least the recent highs of $85 in the near future, in my opinion. Right. If not, you know, pushing it even higher from there. So with the CPI data out this morning, of course, we have the dollar pulling back a little bit, putting bids in that. How do you see, you know, the inflation story playing out over the next weeks or months as that pushes into the dollar? Do you see the inflation as it wanes?
Explode. I think we're going to continue to go on like we did last year. I think that everything pretty much is going to double again over the course of the next year. You know, I really do. I think you're going to see it a lot in the soft commodities, in the meats. I think you're going to see it in all of the hard metals and stuff like that. A lot of the stuff that you use in production. I really think that in the tangible sense of the economy, for commodities especially, you're going to see at least 50% inflation, if not 100% inflation over the course of the next year, which then is going to factor in. Here's the thing we haven't seen a lot of inflation in yet, Tommy, and it really worries me, is that what happens when the service sector starts to hit with inflation? You know, like we all know it, that when we go to the grocery store, the gas pump, or you're buying goods, sure, that we've had it, you know. But if you look at relative services, there hasn't been that much inflation. Well, pretty soon people who are in the service industry are going to be like, well, everything I do in my life, I have to pay twice for, double now.
Totally.
You know, they're going to be like, why wouldn't I charge more money now? You know, so, yeah. And I think that when that hits, we really are going to have a big slowdown in the economy, because it's just going to be such a drag, you know, and especially with we have an economic, or excuse me, an employment situation now we've never had in this country before. We have people that don't want to return to work. And then we have people that are being removed from work because of a choice, you know, whether you get whether you put whatever mandate you want to put down on people. If it impacts employment, you know, this is going to also impact inflation, supply chains. Now we're not even worried about supply chains coming globally. We're going to have our own supply chain issues within the country, you know.
Sure.
So, and that, I think, is something that's going to pan out huge. And it's not going to really hit us too much over the next 3 months. But I think that definitely by the second and third quarter, we're going to be looking back at 2021 and being like, oh, why couldn't we just have that inflation? You know,
but watch out if that comes in, man, because what's so interesting, too, just in light of pretty much what you're saying, is that the estimates right now, you know, we just hit 7%, but that was the estimate. So the market can trade higher when we have a CPI number that's 7% year over year. But that number is supposed to come down dramatically. So it's not hard to hit the estimates in the market to be okay when CPI is supposed to be 7%, folks. But where are we going to be? And that's where, you know, I can't wait as a trader when we're coming into some of those reports, whether it's CPI, whether it's, you know, wage data, that we're supposed to see, and time flies, man. We're going to be there before we know it. We're supposed to see some pretty rapid decreases this coming year. Maybe we'll start getting to the section of, you know, next year that we'll have some comps that might help that out a little bit in terms of where we are. But time is coming, man, and we got to hit those numbers and we'll see what happens.
Right.
Well, Teddy, I appreciate the conversation as always, man, and we look forward
Thank
to
you.
Talking to you next week.
US dollar yen 122, baby.
122. All right, I'm going to write it down. We're going to pull it up next week when we chat with you Wednesday, man.
All right,
have a great week,
care.
Teddy. Thanks, man. Stay tuned, folks. We'll come right back after the break.